Hello everyone, I'm back again. Connie here, CB's coloring in craft. I want to finish this picture. Sorry that I made a mess of the background picture. Well, it is a mess, but the video was a mess also. It wasn't supposed to be that way. I want to do the pearls. And yeah, I think it's a kind of an oyster shell or something. I have picked all pastel colors. I don't know exactly what I'm gonna use, so it's a gray, a yellow, a blue, a white, green, lila, lilac, pink, and a flesh color. First, I want to do something about those lines. I still bleed in this book. My mermaid brush, putting that away. I think I will start with the shell. I said shell, I don't know why, it's a shell. I want to make a kind of a nice basic layer so that there is a little something to grab my pencil on. Like a base, and I'm doing that with a light gray, and that's the gold gray number one, and the number is 230. Nothing fancy, just putting down a basic layer. I like to do that. So I have studied seashell, so I'm just doing something that I think would be nice. And I think I need a little pink. I can zoom in a little more. So that's that. Oh, now it's going back again. Is it doing that? So now it stays okay. Sometimes me and technical stuff is not a good marriage. I'm always so happy that I have my son, who's really good at that sort of thing, and he's kind enough to come and help me. So happy with that, because otherwise I get stuck all the time. And he wants me to do more with my videos, but I'm not confident enough to do that. I have to practice more, but yeah, there's the issue with time again. That's something I'm really short of the moment, and outside they're still making noise, so sorry for that. They are trimming the bushes. So there's a little bit of this. I'm going for the light flesh now. Turning my book so that my hand is not so much in the way, and that you can see what I'm doing. Well, I'm not really sure what I'm doing. I'm just making it up. I'm going. They have some ridges, so that's what I'm trying to make here. Back to the 139 light violet. I think this is one of the colors that is not in the basic set. There are two or three. I think this is one of them, sorry. Snapped my pointer. And I find purple is a nice color to shade, so that's why I'm using that. Skip from. I use that in the face also for shading purple. You can use blue and gray, green. I use green in Herman. Yeah, I like purple better, but because of the green hair, and I think for her it was nice to use the green. I'm not a person that makes a big plan before I start coloring. I'm most of the time I pick my colors just when I'm coloring. And sometimes I think about do I want green hair, do I want brown hair, do I want blue hair. But most of the time I start and then I use what I think will be nice in the picture. Sometimes I make a plan, but most of the times I don't keep the plan. Change when I go along. So why bother if you don't follow your plan? And I'm a bit of a chaotic person, so yeah, I think that's the way it works for me the best. Everybody has to find out what's working for him, for her. A little more blending. It's too stripy for my liking. I hope you can see what I'm doing. I'm really trying to keep my hand out of the way. Now I need some white, and I'm coloring with Polychromos, but for the white I like to use my Prisma or my Luminance, so I think I will use my Luminance for this one. I want a middle light. So that it looks like this, yeah, puffing, is that a word? There are ridges, so it's going up and down. And I think I need a blender. And I like to use my Caran d'Ashwan for that. Make sure my point is clean, because you never know. Yeah, there was some blue on it. This is the Caran d'Ashwan blender. I don't use it a lot, but sometimes I like to use it. I think it's working really nice. Maybe it's a little darker than here. I'm looking for a darker gray, and this is the dark gray number 4233. No shading on here. And with the Caran d'Ashwan blender, you can go over it, doesn't matter. Maybe I'll bring the shading up all the way. Oh, I think this is a quite nice. Maybe I need some more pink. Bringing in some more of the Vlad Light Fresh from the edges to the middle. I must put this one in a pencil or an extender, because then it's easier to hold. Yeah, this is I'm so sorry. This is what I was looking for, I think. Maybe blend it a little more with the white. Yeah, nice light shell. I'm sorry. Now we have to go for the pearls. I'm thinking the same colors, and then I put some stickles on them. Because it's a mermaid, she needs some glittery in her life. I'm just making a darker on the edges with the gray, the same gray I used before. And I want to use the kind of transparent stickle, so you will probably see a bit of the shading when I'm done. I hope you can see that, and that's why I'm doing it. Trying to make them look round. So, the other like so, maybe a little blue in there. For a nice shine, it is the sky blue, the 146. I'm going over the gray and a little bit more to the middle. Not worrying so much about those tiny ones. So, these are the pearls. It's not doing what I want. There must be something in between. It doesn't do that. No. This is better. Would be nice if they do what you want and not what they want. And let me have a look at my stickles. What shall I do? I have frosted lace, I have twinkle, and I have diamonds. Yeah, no, not a frosted lace because that's kind of a white one. I also have a blue, but I don't think I want a blue. I think I go with a twinkle. So I'm always using it straight from the bottle. And I know I'm using it in a coloring book, so when I color another page, I have to put some papers behind, but I don't mind. That's okay for me. I don't care. I like the effect so much that I still use it. And when you put a bunch of papers behind it, it will still work. I've done it a couple of times. I'm okay with it. You see, this is pretty transparent, so you'll see the shading that I did before. Otherwise, you only have glittery circles. That's not the effect I'm looking for. Oh, I skipped one. Just looking that I do the whole thing. With those big ones, you sometimes skip little pieces. I hope you don't find this too boring seeing me putting stickles on the page. So, I always clean the little thing on the bottle before I put the lid back on. So, that's done. Let me think about something else to do with her. I have that sparkle on the water, and it's a shame the camera doesn't pick it up because it is a really pretty shine. Not too much, just nice. Maybe we can do some wink of Stella over the no, this is orange. This is the clear. I also have one from Nouveau. It's some similar thing. There is a little difference, but not much. This is the link of Stella. You can see there is a difference in the brush. The link of Stella brush is much finer than the other one. Yeah, the Wink of Stella has more glitter. I don't think you can see it on the camera, but the Wink of Stella has more glitter. This is a cheaper one, but it works. And now I have to be careful because my stickles are still wet. I have to keep my hand in here. So now we have to do something with those bubbles. I'm thinking a white gel pen. And I think I will go with a 10 because those lines are pretty thick. Let me see if it's working. Yes, it is. I'm out of the camera again. I'm just going over those black lines. And those neos, they are kind of transparent, so you can still see them. Easy. Those glitter is coming off a little, but I sprayed it with a fixative. It's not too bad. I think I'm going to do this as well. When my pen is working. Sometimes it is, sometimes it isn't. The thing with these pens is that you must really be light on your pressure. And I find it difficult to see where I'm going when I'm so light. They work best when you're hardly touching the paper. Well, that's not a big problem if you see a little of the black lines. Just want them not to be that black. Almost done, and just a few in the sky. I turn my book around because my stickles are still wet. It's nothing much to see, I'm just making black lines white, kind of. This little I don't know. Is it clover blood? I don't know. It's the dead Irish thing that makes me think of the green hair. That was my inspiration for the green hair. I want to make some white dots over here because this is a very empty space. I don't like that. Maybe a little star as well. So. And I do the same over here. Oh, I lost my hand in the stickles, of course. Oh, I'm so clumsy. I should wait with those stickles till it's done. Did I use not? I did not use the diamond. I did use the twinkle. I have to bring some back in. I should have done this in the last part. So, they are back. Maybe a bubble over here. Like some white dots in here. So, I like that. I was thinking of doing some dotting in her hair, but I decided I don't. In her eye. The only thing I need to do is a bit of shading in her eye. I forgot that. Now we have the testing of the alarm. They do that every first Monday of the month at noon. So now you know I did this picture at noon. They are really working with me today. So, yeah, I think she's finished. Oh, I did it off camera. I'm so sorry. I'm such an idiot. Well, this is what I did. Some blue in her eyes. Now you see me do it. I'm such an idiot. I'm so sorry for that. So, this is how she's turning out. I'm sorry you can't see the nice shine of the makeup powder. Not even when I bend the paper, I think maybe just a little. And the stickles on the... I think you can see... Can you see the stick? You must can see the stickles on the... No? Well, that's silly. Stickles are so shiny. Now, this is how she turned out. I hope you liked this video. I think it was a little bit better than the other one. But, well, maybe my next videos will be better. I'm still learning. Thank you for watching. Bye, and maybe till next time.